What if you could convert a continuously rotating motion into a back and forth linear motion without using any electronics or sensors? In this video, I'm going to show you a fascinating mechanical system called the auto-reversing chain mechanism. This clever setup uses a rotating sprocket to make the chain itself move in both directions, creating a reciprocating motion from a single direction of input. I'll show you how I designed this mechanism in SolidWorks, how I got the parts 3D printed from JLC 3DP, and finally, how I assembled and tested it. Let's jump into it. The magic of this mechanism lies in its asymmetrical cam profile and chain guiding system. Here's how it works. The central sprocket is designed with alternating contact points. As it rotates, these contact points push and pull the chain in alternating directions. One part of the gear's profile engages with the top side of the chain and moves it forward. As the gear continues to rotate, a different cam arm pulls on the lower part of the chain and moves it backward, creating automated back and forth movement of the chain while the sprocket spins continuously in one direction. After finalizing the design in SolidWorks and checking tolerances, I exported all the STL files for printing. For accurate and smooth motion, I needed clean prints with tight tolerances, so I uploaded my design files to JLC 3DP, choose the material, and hit order. And if you want to try it yourself, the link is in the description. Just a few days later, I received my 3D printed parts from JLC 3DP. The quality was impressive. Each cam profile was sharp, and the sprocket had just the right dimensions. Everything fit together nicely without any sanding or tweaking. This is one reason I keep going back to them for high-precision mechanism builds. Now it was time to put it all together. I started by mounting the sprocket on the rotating shaft, then fixed the chain loop around it, and secured the guide rails. The key part was positioning the cams so that they engage the chain from opposite sides alternately. And here's the final working test. I powered the sprocket in one direction. And as you can see, the chain first moves forward, then reverses, then forward again, automatically. All of this from a single continuous rotational input. Mechanisms like this are ideal for converting rotary input into oscillating output without using electronics. Whether you're building an automatic wiper blade system, a cutting table, or a mechanical display, this system is compact, elegant, and purely mechanical. I've added the link to JLC 3DP in the description if you'd like to get your parts printed just like I did. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe if you enjoy mechanical innovations like this. Let me know in the comments what mechanism you'd like me to make next. Thanks for watching.